This week on Maker Update, robot eyes that can actually see, a crash course in productizing your design, and a non-murderous robot for your ceiling. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update where we collect the coolest new DIY projects and tips from across the internet. I hope you're doing well. I've got a great show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. Will Cogley's 3D printed eye mechanism has quickly become the go-to solution for anyone trying to make their own animatronic robot or Halloween monster. But ironically, the one thing his eyes can't do is see. That is, until now. With no small amount of effort, Will has designed a new version of his eye mechanism that fits a small USB-connected camera using a flat ribbon cable. Another new aspect of this design is a rotating base engineered around a 3D printed thrust bearing. This gives the mechanism the greatest degree of panning movement and stability. And then there's the psychological aspect of the design. There's something inherently unnerving about having a pair of eyes tracking you around a room, and when those eyes belong to a robot skull, it's genuinely terrifying. So, to soften things up, Will challenged himself to make an enclosure that's actually kind of cute. Definitely a departure from the more anatomically accurate and intricate designs, but it's nice to have an animatronic project that you don't have to hide in a closet when your friends come over. Finally, to bring the whole thing to life, Will's included a carefully calibrated Python script that can perform face detection using Google's MediaPipe machine learning algorithm. In this script, to help minimize jerkiness and make the effect a little more human, the tracking is first done by the eyes, and is only followed by a head pivot once a person sticks around long enough. It's a great project, and Will has generously included all the code and STL files for the design on his website. You can find a link to his video and to the files down in the description. Now for some news. Raspberry Pi announced the launch of a new 5-inch touchscreen. The new screen shares the same 720 by 1280 resolution as the larger 7-inch model that Raspberry Pi continues to sell, as well as the same capacitive multi-touch capability. The screen retails for around $40, and I think the star feature here compared to other options is the native plug-and-play compatibility for the Raspberry Pi computer. It takes its power from the Pi and includes built-in standoffs for mounting the computer to the back of the screen. I'll include a DigiKey link down in the description. More projects! On the Unnecessary Inventions channel, there's an inspiring video on how Matty Benedetto took this animated LED mirror design from a concept to a retail-ready product. As a project, within the first minute, he explains how he made the proof of concept using a mirror he found and some off-the-shelf lighting strip. For me, what makes this video essential viewing is that we get to see what's involved in taking a concept like this and polishing it into a real product. Some of that's a question of making it look nicer, like how do you hide the LEDs for a nicer profile, or how do you affordably upgrade to nicer materials and eliminate the 3D printed plastics? Some of it's a question of scalability. How do you outsource the manufacturing of different elements of the product so that you can keep up with demand if it does become a hit? And what ties into both of those really is how to optimize the electronics so that fabricated boards can drop in and plug together with minimal assembly. The short answer to a lot of these problems is to make use of the PCB and CNC fabrication services available now, but it's still on you to optimize the design so that it's practical and affordable. More importantly, it's on you to come up with a cool idea. For a project that's neither practical nor affordable, but is 100% amazing, check out this GLaDOS-inspired ceiling-mounted robot arm made by Tom from the Made with Layers channel. To be fair, there actually is a practical goal for this project, which is to make a smooth CNC camera dolly for filming videos. But we're definitely getting there in style. For example, in the spirit of GLaDOS, the business end of the arm here is a Stewart platform, a multi-joint mechanism I often see in ball balancing platforms. Working out the kinematics for a platform like this can be a real headache, but holy moly does it look cool. As you move up the arm though, the joints seem to get increasingly practical and robust, terminating in what looks like a stepper motor-driven belt drive system to spin it around. It's an incredible project, and the execution and engineering are inspiring. Check it out. Now for some tips and tools. By way of a New York Times article, actually, I learned about a new breakthrough in origami folding patterns made by a BYU student named Zhongyuan Yang. These patterns are described as bloom patterns for reasons that should seem obvious. Scientifically, they're notable for being rotationally symmetrical and radially expansive, which is to say that they don't expand in and out in a column, but rather expand out from the center. What a lot of these articles aren't mentioning is that not only is the academic paper for this not hidden behind a paywall, but the downloadable material includes SVG fold pattern files, videos, and even Python code for recreating and experimenting with these and other patterns. I think there's a ton of potential here for foldable projects, wearables, fashion, robotics, and it's all here for you to play with. Another technique I'm interested in playing with is this trick for making embedded capacitive touch buttons in 3D prints. The tip here comes from John Phillips on Instructables. In his guide, he shows how to design a 4-button panel and use your slicer to create a pause layer partway through the print. This pause gives you a chance to lay down copper tape within the button wells and then resume your print, which continues to go right over the surface of the tape. It's a cool idea, and it really doesn't require any extra exotic materials, no conductive filament, no specialty conductive breakout boards. And though the example here is pretty straightforward in terms of button design, what I think is really cool is that you're completely free to reimagine your buttons in any shape or size you want. There's no reason your button needs to look like a button or call attention to itself at all. For certain projects, that could be a real asset. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, they've got a new unboxing video out on their product discovery channel. We get to see what comes with the MPLAB PICkit Basic In-Circuit Debugger from Microchip. The kit retails for just over $30. It's a pocket-sized PIC programmer and debugger. Sometimes you need an easy way to program or test a microcontroller that doesn't come pre-installed with its own USB hardware for talking to your computer. That's where a PIC programmer comes in handy. Check out the video to see if it's right for you. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. A big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.